But I think to me the scariest thing in food is that expiration date on the milk. They really, they scare you with it, you know? Do you ever have milk the day after the day? You know, and the spoon is trembling as it comes out of the thing. It's after the day! How do they know that that is the exact day? You know what I mean? It's just so definite. They brand it right into the side of the carton. That's your day right there. Do the cows tip them off when they're milking them, you know? July 3rd. You think they sat around the Beef Association? How about Bonkers Beef Syndrome? What do you think of that? No, no, no. It doesn't sound serious enough. Silly meat condition. No, 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 no. Look, come on, Frank. It's 11. Let's get out of here. How about Mad Cow? Mad Cow? All right, we're going with the Mad Cow. Just, you know, I don't know what the hell it is.
Telephone.
Hello?
Are Kramer and Elaine still there?
Yeah, Kramer and Elaine still here.
Who is that?
No, don't tell them it's me.
I left my keys there, but I can't come back up after an exit like that.
Is that George?
Yeah.
Come on, let me talk to him. Hey, George, listen, you know that thing that you said about actors? I'm not sure I get it.
Let me talk to him just for a second. Let me talk. You know what? That didn't really make sense. Because bacterial meningitis is not a small disease. And well, hang on.
I'm afraid they're right.
Yeah. Be right up.
Here you are, one shrimp salad.
Plenty of shrimp. We should start running out of shrimp.
Hey, George. The ocean called. They're running out of shrimp.
Oh, yeah? Well, the jerk store called. They're running out of you.
Nobody busts my chops.
Congratulations, George. Oh,
yeah. Number one.
Great.
I am nothing.
Anything else?
No, thanks.
Hey, you're still bald. Anything else?
No, thanks.
Oh, boy. Okay.
Nice whiz van, huh? Got it really cheap because this guy's friend saw his parents having sex in it.
Can we please just have dinner?
Yeah. I get a break in an hour. Attention!
Attention!
Where can you get the best deals on consumer electronics? Why, at Nobody Beats the Liz!
And how do I know this? Because I'm the whiz! Because I'm the whiz. I'm the whiz.
Jack, get back in the van.
This is my whiz, lady. Lady whiz.
Jack.
I can't make this work. Repeat.
Can't make this work.
I'm gonna do it.
What? After what you just went through, I thought you said you'd never say it again.
Just once, I'd like to say it to somebody that can hear it!
George, I am like the ghost of relationship future. I have just shown you what can happen, and you're still gonna fire Bob Cratchit.
I'm not only canning Cratchit, I might just take that little crybaby Tiny Tim down a few pegs. Yeah!
Sienna, I love you.
I love you too.
Will you marry me?
Yeah.
Great.
Thanks a lot. Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Oh, that Lloyd Braun, he is something, isn't he? And he's an advisor to Giuliani.
You know, it's not just politics with advisors. They get involved with all facets of the candidates' lives. They tell them what shoes to wear, what cologne to use.
And he's so handsome. His mother tells me he has a beautiful apartment.
What kind of soap? Etiquette things, too. How many ice cubes to use? Because politicians are observed so closely.
It's a very important position.
Doesn't tell him how many ice cubes to use.
That's what he does, George. The candidate is in his hands.
It was the one issue which seemed to electrify the voters and swept Giuliani into office.
So in effect, a yogurt won him the election.
I wonder what actually happened in that lab.
Yeah, me too.
Look who's here.
That name tag was a great idea.
Hey, my father liked it.
Ow!
Oh, you can cut the arm crap, too. I spoke to the doctor.
Yeah, well, it's real this time.
This stinks.
I can't eat this!
Whoa. Somebody ought to smooth that.
All right, everybody. Be good.
All right, here you go, boys. One funked up mattress.
You know, we're not responsible for stench.
I know. You can just bill me for the new one. Hey, fellas, can you give me a hand with this one? Fellas? Damn lumbar yard. You know what? Next time I'm calling Spine-tastic. Okay.
Yes, yes, come in.
Sir? Just got a call from a terrorist. I told him to call back here if you have a minute.
Hey, Costanza, I'm in the middle of a jumble. Squawk, what is that? Have I got it? Is that the word?
Let me put this on speaker for you, sir.
Hello, bomber? Is that you?
Yeah, this is a terrorist bomber.
You know, Costanza here is busting his hump on those hats.
You know, about those hats, I was kicking it around with some of my other terrorist buddies, and I think I changed my mind.
You don't want them? They're gone. Goodbye.
Good thinking, sir.
Now, what do you want instead?
What?
Well, you're the terrorist. You got to want something.
Yes, how about some demands? Certainly, you must have some ideas about personnel changes. I hear Reggie Jackson is available.
Reggie Jackson?
You do realize he's an old man now, don't you? His knees are made out of sponge cake, for God's sake. He has to go upstairs backwards.
Really?
I'm sure the terrorist didn't mean as a player. I'm sure the terrorist meant, to have around the office, kind of like to hang out.
Man, he's so full of himself with that candy bar and everything.
That's too much nougat.
Well, he said it. That's what he wants.
No, I didn't. Back to the hats idea.
He's bluffing, sir.
No, I'm not. And just because you put your hand over the phone doesn't mean I can't hear what you're saying. No, I want the hats.
Fine. Reggie and hats.
Just hats.
Costanza, what the hell are you doing?
Oh, no, we have to stand tough, sir. That's why I had to hang up the phone.
Nope, I'm still here. You must have pressed the wrong button. Remember, I want the same hats that the players wear.
We cannot negotiate with a madman like that, sir.
Oh, that was a very big mistake. When someone's unstable, you don't stir the pot, George.
The best thing to do is to just keep calm and get Reggie Jackson.
We better watch our backs. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to run around the stadium and close all the windows. That's what I'm doing, pal. And I'll tell you something else. I am very nervous.
Hello? Oh. Oh, my goodness. What happened?
I beat my older brother.
Excuse me?
I beat my older brother in tennis yesterday for the first time in my life. I beat him.
Oh, that's great.
I never played like that before. It was the brew line. I couldn't miss with it. It was like I was born to play with that racket.
Well, it does have
a big... And then when the match was over, I decided I had to jump over the net. As you can see, I didn't quite make it. I tore my humeral epicondylitis.
Oh, well, the humeral
The doctors say it may never fully heal. I may never play again.
Why didn't you just ask her for it?
I told you I couldn't. The woman was crying about how she might never play tennis again.
But it's not her racket.
Jerry, this woman is in a cast with a torn humidor. Epicondylitis. I mean, you know, it's like asking a dying man for his shoes.
Why is a dying man wearing my shoes?
I am not going to get into another analogy thing with you here, okay? Suffice it to say that I have a chance at getting a real job in my chosen field. And I didn't want to take the chance of offending her and having to go back to picking the salt off of Mr. Pitt's pretzels.
Believe me, there are worse jobs than picking salt off of someone's pretzels.
Like what?
Well, how about patting oil off a pizza?
Well, thank God I haven't had to do that. I just don't enjoy being with him.
Well, that's what's important.
How do you pronounce S-C-O-U-R-G-E?
Scourge.
See, I said scourge. And then Owen makes this really big deal about it in front of this other couple. He really embarrassed me. That's it. That's it. I cannot date and watch my grammar at the same time.
That's not grammar, that's pronunciation.
Hey, don't you get smart.
I was moving it across the street. I looked up and I saw Woody Allen. I got all distracted.
It's not even my car. It's a rental.
Did you get the insurance?
Yeah, I got the insurance, but so what? What are you doing out there? You're holding up the production of the movie. We can't shoot. Woody's really mad at you.
Woody mentioned you? What did he say?
He said, who's the moron out there in the blue jacket who's got the street all screwed up?
Woody called me a moron?
Yeah, George, he's really upset. I didn't want to say anything because I don't even want him to know that I knew you.
Jerry, do I have to go with him? You know, I was just about to break up.
Elaine, come on. 7 dates, sexual activity. I believe you're under contract.
Yeah. But it's an act of God.
Call me from the hospital.
Should I apologize to Woody?
George, Woody's got enough on his mind right now without having to deal with you. All right, I'll tell you what. Next time I talk to him, maybe I'll bring it up. I'll feel him out.
I have been waiting for this refill for like 10 minutes. All right, that's it. I'm going back there, and I'm getting it myself.
You've been saying that for years.
No. This time I mean it. I'm going behind that counter.
You can't go back there.
Why not?
You don't go back there. You don't do it.
I'm going in.
I don't know you. Hey, some woman's getting her own coffee. Oh, thank you.
You know, Elaine, if we don't make that Prince William children's pajamas flame retardant, we can save an extra 30 cents a unit.
Wait till I tell Jacopo.
You mean Mr. Peterman?
No, he told me to call him Jacopo.
You know what? Let's not wait until tomorrow. We should have this meeting right away.
What time?
How about this afternoon? Around 4:30.
After dinner?
So, you want to come down to Mario's Pizza with me and help me pick up the Frogger?
Hey, how are you going to keep the machine plugged in while you move it?
What?
Once you unplug the machine, all the scores will be erased.
You're right.
Why must there always be a problem? You think just once I could get a break? God knows I earned it with that score!
Are the refills transferable?
Coming in!
Hey, the lock's broken.
So this is how you get your jollies?
Well, I feel pretty good right now.
Oh, Jerry, you should have seen her.
I did.
Oh, you didn't see her coming out of that bathroom. She was like Venus rising out of the sea.
Was there a flood in there?
Oh, hey, Elaine. Oh, you got the munchies?
Well, Kramer, I'm in big, big, big trouble. I need a cake that looks like this.
Huh? Oh, yeah, Sotheby's. Yeah, they make good cake.
Do any of these look close?
No. But I know I've seen cake just like that.
Oh,
Enemans, yeah.
Enemans? From the supermarket?
Well, no, they're not really in the supermarket. Yeah, they got their own case at the end of the aisle. Oh, my goodness, there she is.
Who?
My Venus from the bathroom. Ooh, give me one of those. Hi there. We met at the bathroom. Can I offer you a piece of cake?
No, thank you.
Wait, listen,
you know, I like you a lot!
So, we meet again. Sit, bathroom lady. See, would you like a little champagne?
What is this, some kind of detour through here?
You must be doing some construction on the street.
I don't believe this city.
Hey, George,
how many in your party?
I was just walking my dog.
Do you people have a reservation?
Is anyone even working in the bank anymore? I mean, what are they doing? Is it just pretending, you know, shuffling papers around, talking on phones that aren't even plugged in, you know? I think the bank building is just a charade that they have to keep going because they need that 2 feet of wall to hold up the cash machine. I think my favorite dog thing is when you have to leave him in the car and he's just sitting there in the front seat. Because the dog body in the car seat is the only time that your head and his head are at the same height. You know what I mean? Because they love when they're up there in the front. They go, this is more like it. I think you and I should be together all the time. Except when they turn. When you turn, they can't handle the turns. You know, I got no thumbs. Take it easy. Good dogs stick their heads out the window. They love that in the car, don't they? I don't know what it does for them, but there is just no doubt that this is the thing. You know, when they are doing that, I don't know what they're thinking, like, boy, if I could run this fast. But, you know, I don't know what they're thinking.
People, there must be a million ideas out there. Now, something somebody could wear. Anything. Oh, sweet Judy. You open up a closet and you pull out. What?
We are so screwed. They were the best ribs that she or I had ever sunk our aching molars into. The greasy sauce dripped from our chins onto our tight-fitting bibs. It was electric.
God.
I offered her a wet nap. She didn't refuse. From that point on, there was little she would refuse.
All right, well, this has been delightful. But I'm afraid we can't use any of it. You see, it turns out Mr. Peterman is allergic to pork.
These were beef ribs. Later that evening, we returned to my apartment. And here, we dimmed the lights and satisfied a hunger of a different kind. Chicken wings. The next morning, I awoke in a pile of bones, and she was gone.
Here's your $8.
Yes.
Wow. That was a hell of a kiss.
I'll tell you, we got tremendous kiss compatibility.
You think so?
Oh, yeah, there was great meshing going on there.
It's all about meshing.
You know, I talk to you, it's like I'm talking to myself.
Yeah, it's very strange.
Very strange.
Well, what do you want to do now?
How about one more kiss, then we watch the Met game?
Oh. Fantastic!
Beautiful.
I first noticed some discomfort a few days after my routine gallbladder operation.
Uh-huh. And what kind of discomfort?
I felt full all the time. Plus, I could drink like 2 gallons of water, no problem.
Okay.
My surgeon seemed disorganized. He was always losing stuff.
Anything else?
I float easier now. I love cake. What's the kind that's yellow and squidgy, not pound cake, but blank cake?
Layer cake.
Ah, go to hell.
All right, Mr. Peterman, the credits were over 10 minutes ago. Okay, let's go. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Elaine, I've got an idea. Let's watch it again.
But Mr. Peterman,
sit down. I want you to take notes on all these clothes so we can knock them off.
Oh, no.
Elaine, it's just a game of celebrity name scramble.
I guess I just know it's coming.
Stevens Bergsby.
It's Steven Spielberg.
No. Gutters.